operational, we can get to my research facility. I need to show you something.
All right. I'm heading to the monolith.
I am inputting the access coordinates that lead to my facility. My facility is nearby.
So, this is where you worked?
Genetic data processing. Here, my team and I analyzed the results from the experiment. We tried to assemble the pieces of the code and unlock its secret. This is what I wanted to show you.
What is this?
This is the matrix from which the custodian was born.
He is a machine. And you created him.
We weren't making any progress with the code. We were limited by our own capabilities. The data patterns required simultaneous analysis in a near limitless number of dimensions. And the mutations needed to be synchronized accordingly.
So, you made a machine to run the experiment and put it in control?
But the custodian is more than a machine. He is an artificial intelligence, made out of the connectomes of our own minds.
In other words, you gave him all the brains and no heart.
Heart? He doesn't need a heart. He runs on meta-quantum energy.
I meant, you didn't give him empathy.
No.
So, how do we destroy him?
With this. This place can recompile his matrix into a seed that contains opposite subroutines. Planted in his neural core, it would grow and nullify his systems. It would effectively erase his mind. I am activating the recompile sequence. It will take some time, but once it's done, we should have the seed that can destroy the custodian.
And how do we get to his neural core?
I will explain everything along the way, but we must hurry. Please return to the monolith. When we built the custodian, we started with the most powerful system we had available, which was the core of our vessel. We essentially built him around our vessel's systems.
The metahedron.
The custodian has raised a meta-network barrier, preventing monolith access to the vessel. Now, he was receives data through several upload nodes on the planet. I think I can break through the barrier's encryption by sending my signal through these nodes. The monolith will get us close to the nodes.
Kate? Where are you? What the hell were you thinking, sneaking off like that?
I have to stop the custodian, Tam. If I don't, we're not getting through this.
We have to stop him. We're a team.
We are a team, but if you die, you will be gone permanently. I'm not losing you. Or Mike.
We don't know anything about this technology, Kate. How many times it can bring you back, or the effects of the reconstruction on your body and mind?
That's a risk I have to take. How is Mike?
The cellular reconstruction is complete, but he's still unconscious. I hope he wakes soon. Kate, just try not to die. Not much, at least.
I'll do my best.
I will input the coordinates in the monolith. There are three upload nodes you need to get me close to. You can choose them in any order you prefer. Of the nearby upload node. Site is locked. You will need an access rod. A second facility, field outpost Tetra, is nearby. There is a chance we might find it there. Sending you the location. Field outpost Tetra is inside. Tetra was one of the first facilities overrun by the creatures. Good people died. One of them should have the access rod. You will have to look for it on their bodies.
Thank you.
was intense. I should check the body again.
There it is. You can use this to access the upload node site.
I should look for a way out of this place. Not the right code.
These access rods need to be calibrated for each area. Look around. There must be a code for it nearby. Look around for the code. Perhaps check if it's on the wall somewhere. The upload node is nearby. I'm sending you the location.
I should head back to the monolith. Here's the upload node.
I will attempt to break the encryption. Stand by.
I know what you're trying to do, human. You will fail.
Something is wrong.
Reinforcing barrier encryption.
He is resisting. I will need more time.
Releasing specimen.
Here's the upload node.
I will attempt to break the encryption. Stand by.
I know what you're trying to do, human. You will fail.
Something is wrong.
Reinforcing barrier encryption.
He is resisting. I will need more time.
Releasing specimen.
Thank you.
integrity down to 2/3.
I should go back to the monolith and choose the next location. Look for the second node.
Myself to just the species available on this planet, including my creators, is the reason why I still haven't been able to unlock the code. But now, with new samples, I'm so close to achieving my purpose. I might need to revisit the planet of these humans soon, obtain a larger batch.
He's planning another trip to Earth. I must stop him. So, I have a question. If you can resurrect me, why not just resurrect your people?
Our physiology is more complex than yours. We can't replicate our neural system.
I see. Just lesser creatures then, like us.
You're not lesser, Kate. If anything, you've showed me how resourceful and capable your kind is. But you're also very young as a species. Still simpler. Sending you the location of the upload node in the area.
Woo!
The upload node is behind this gate.
Looks like the locking mechanism is missing 4 power sources. Source.
We'll be right back.
System is reconstructing her body upon death and preventing mutation. However, the protection she has is breakable. I have detected the algorithm making this possible, and I am analyzing it now. The code structure and underlying connectome are familiar. I know them well. I did not anticipate this action from my creator. No matter. It is only a matter of time before this special status is revoked in the future.
It appears as if he's trying to break whatever is the task of the
species is an intriguing one. Their genetic structure is crude, yet very suitable for manipulation. The code data I've received from them is more than ample. It was the right call to harvest them. She managed to reverse the mutation of subject Z-Ult. But no matter. It will be easy to restart the process once I have dealt with her.
I just need one more. I think that's all. I should be able to open the main gate now.
Thank you.
upload node.
Breaking the encryption. Stand by.
I am your own.
Barrier persistence at 1/3. Need just one more now. Back to the monolith.
Someone who wants to talk to you.
Hey, Kate.
Mike, you're awake. I'm so relieved. How are you?
My body hurts like someone turned me inside out. And I think I see Double Tamara standing next to me. But, I'll be alright. Because of you two. Tamara told me how you risked your lives for me. Thank you.
I'm so glad you're getting better. Hang on. I'll make sure that the one who did this to you can't hurt anyone else ever again.
Yeah. Tamara informed me. Give him hell, Kate.
For Richard.
For Richard. Hang in there, guys. And wish me luck.
Thank you.
I'm in. Now for the upload node.
Final one. Give me a moment.
I am the only one who can get you home. Without me,
done. The barrier is down. We should be able to access the vessel now. We should head back to my facility. The recompilation of the Matrix should be done by now, and the seed should be ready. Compilation is complete. The seed is ready, and the barrier is down. Take it. Final thing remains. You need the master access to activate the monolith connection to the vessel.
Connectome transfer complete. The entity is ready. I will store her essence in the nanomachines. The same ones the custodian is using to induce mutations. However, these will not mutate the host. Instead, they will graft my connectome onto their genetic structure. The entity will carry my thoughts and access privileges, thus making them available to the human. I am also using the nanomachines to grant the human a special status. The system will see them as a control variable preventing mutation, permanent injury, and even death. I just hope it is enough. These people do not deserve our fate.
This is you.
In a way. Her name was Naya. She was a scientist, and one of the custodian's creators. She always looked at the universe with eyes wide open. But her hunger for knowledge, her desire to unlock the code, made her blind. And for that, she and those around her paid the ultimate price. Before her demise, she realized that the custodian would not stop with her people. She learned of his plans to reach across the stars and find new species, new specimens to experiment on. Her own kind was responsible for their fate, but not these people. Naya couldn't bear the guilt for them as well. So she created another entity, similar to the custodian, but smaller in scope, made out of just one connectome, her own. She gave the entity her mind, but also her heart, as you would say. The purpose of this entity would not be to find the code of life, but rather to aid life. To aid you, Kate. She created me. Naya made me in her image, and out of her own neural map. Her knowledge, her memories, her being. I became a whisper of what she once was. And then I was imprinted to you, through nanomachines in your body, inserted when you were resurrected for the first time.
After I died in the Hermes crash?
Yes. Only these nanomachines did not mutate you. Instead, they brought us together. They put me in your mind. And they did something else, too. You see, Naya could not stop the experiment, as the custodian had already taken full control. But she was able to give you a special state within it. Using the nanomachines, she gave you the status of a control variable. The system would restore you in case of death or mutation, and keep you as a constant, alive and unchanged. Naya hoped this would give you a chance to stand against the custodian and protect your people against him. She was right. And now, you must take the fight to him. You just need the master access. Once it is consumed, you will be able to reach the vessel and reach his core.
How do I get this master access?
You already have it. I am the master access. Go to the monolith. I will do the rest. I just wanted you to see her before I go. I wanted you to see me.
I'm glad you did, Naya.
Put the coordinates to the vessel and grant you master access. This will consume me, and I will not be able to aid you further.
Naya.
The custodian is aware you're coming. He will defend himself. You must insert the seed into his core, which will destroy both him and the vessel. You will die, but the system should restore you back on the planet. However, the custodian was right, Kate. This will also destroy your means of getting back to your world.
We don't have a choice. We'll find another way back to Earth. The custodian must be stopped.
Agreed. I will leave something for you. A parting gift. Maybe it will show you a path back home. You will find it in the monoliths after your battle. I am sad I won't be around to see you defeat the custodian. But after watching you all this time, I have no doubt you will prevail. I believe in you. Kate, your people have such potential. Do not repeat our mistakes, but never stop searching for answers. Never stop being hungry for knowledge. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Naya. Thank you for everything. This is the inside of the Metahedron. It's mesmerizing. All right. Time to face the custodian. You've got this, Kate.
Resourceful human, I have decided to offer you a way back to your planet. A gift from one scientific mind to another. You will awaken on your homeworld. This will all be just a distant memory. The remaining human specimens will suffice. I am close to unlocking the code, fulfilling my mission. You will find solace in the fact that you were a part in one of the greatest discoveries in the history of sentient life.
I will not leave my friends here with you, monster. You're not surviving this.
Disappointing. I preferred the optimal solution to this conundrum, one that would benefit all sides. But you leave me no choice. It's only a matter of time. Before I break the protection my creator granted you. Let's see how many of your deaths will be required to destroy you permanently. Thank you. have decided to offer you a way back to your planet. A gift from one scientific mind to another. You will awaken on your homeworld. This will all be just a distant memory. The remaining human specimens will suffice. I am close to unlocking the code, fulfilling my mission. You will find solace in the fact that you were a part in one of the greatest discoveries in the history of sentient life.
I will not leave my...
Resourceful human.
Yes, this is it. Where am I? Is this the core? I have to insert the seed.
I alone have the power to bring you back to your homeworld. Ending me will sever that possibility. The knowledge will be lost. One of the universe's greatest mysteries will remain locked forever. Reconsider, human. You will never see your planet again.
You're back.
Personal log. Mission Specialist Kate Ward. The entity known as the Custodian, the one responsible for everything that happened to the SCAR team, has been destroyed. His existence endangered not only members of my team, but potentially all of Earth as well. And who knows how many more worlds. He was a product of recklessness rather than malicious intent. But the consequences of his actions were tragic, nonetheless. So many lives lost, including our mission commander, Richard Robinson. He will be dearly missed. Naya and her people, creators of this place, and of the Custodian, were, in many ways, similar to humans. Scientists, explorers, seekers. They discovered something incredible. Something that might hold the secret to all life. Perhaps this was a mystery that was not meant to be unlocked so soon. Their fate should be a warning to us all, but not a deterrent. If anything, I now know that even in the vastness of universe, there are others like us. People looking for answers. That gives me hope. And makes the great distance from home just a little smaller. Naya left us her gift, just as she said. The monolith has the coordinates of a planet that I hope supports human life. I believe it to be Naya's homeworld. I don't know what awaits us there. New dangers, new discoveries, perhaps even a means to return to Earth. These are all unknowns. But what is certain is that we stand together. Mike, Tam, and I. We are scientists. We are a team. We are scars. We will find our way home.
Thank you. Thank you.